How's it going, YouTube? Mitch Santoni here with an Asia premiere series. This is Transformers Dark of the Moon Striker Optimus Prime. All right, folks, so this is the Buster Prime from Revenge of the Fallen, basically, with the Striker Prime armor, but he's all chromed up and silvered up, and he looks really awesome. So I never had the original Striker Prime. I was going to wait for it to come down in price, which it never did. But I'm kind of glad I waited, because now this guy's all chromey and delicious. So this is what it looks like back in the box. It's like a big, almost like a masterpiece, heavy black box. I kind of like that. And then this is really neat. It's like it's got a magnet here on the side, and that opens up. And then it's book style. So look at that. It shows you how awesome it's going to be once it's opened. Shows you a little bit of a bio there. And then here he is waiting to burst out of the package in all of his glorious awesomeness. So why don't we bust him out right now? All right, here he is in robot mode out of the box. Oh, man, does he look nice. He looks really, 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 really nice. I gotta say, I'm digging me some Buster Prime. This thing looks incredible. He's all chrome and silver, and I'm just kind of ogling at it. It's very impressive to have in hand. Now, I have a Dark of the Moon Buster mold, I guess, if you want to call it that. And that was the Jetwing Prime. Now, it's the same mold as this, but it's just not all chromed and silvered up. This thing looks amazing looking. He's all shiny and making my eyes just happy. All right, so now that we've seen the figure, let's look at the accessories and goodies that he comes with. First up, a couple of really awesome looking swords. I'm totally digging these things. They're all silver painted and orange is semi-translucent. You can kind of see my finger back there. Got some little Cybertronian symbols carved in. A lot of screws in the back, but these things are nice and heavy and kind of fun looking. They can be inserted as such, but the little post here also allows them to be loaded onto his arm in other fashions. Oh, and there he is wielding those two double-bladed orange swords of death. I gotta say, this is a win. So to get our boy wielding his shield, there is a retractable, it's a swiveling post here that plugs into his hand, so he can hold it out and in front of him in a very aggressive type manner. Or when he's standing next to the coffee machine, just chilling out, kind of shooting the breeze with Ultra Magnus, you can plug the top of that port into here, and now he's in a more casual position. IMO, shield plus sword, FTW. Next up we have the Eliminator gun and the Assault Blaster, and yes, they do have names. So these things are kind of fun in their own right. If you pull back like this and then swing that little switch over, it looks like more of a, like a crossbow type weapon, which crossbows are always pretty awesome. And of course the other one does pretty much the same. Whether it be guns, whether it be swords, I'll tell you what, man, dual wielding any kind of weapon for Optimus looks money. Cool thing about these guys is that they form one super duper weapon. You put them back into their normal forms here. Take the small one, stick it in the back of the big one. Now you got a giant laser cannon. I gotta say, the sword plus the shield combination of weaponry may be my favorite, but wow, that super duper cannon and the shield sure isn't far behind. So this is a Buster Prime in vehicle mode, and I've got all the weapons here. Now there's a couple different ways you can attach all this stuff. I'm gonna show you one right now. Alright, to attach all the stuff in the back, you get the shield mode in this configuration, basically the robot mode. You put the robot post down and you swing up this bigger port. That goes into the trailer hitch section. And it will click in. After you hear the click, you know it's good to go. And this kind of hangs off the back and gives the effect of like some thrusters back here. Then you can pull your guns apart and you plug them in so that they face this way. Like such in both of these ports. And it doesn't show it in the instructions, but I like to add the swords on in this part as well. So that now you can store all of his weapons in his vehicle mode. And he looks pretty darn cool. Now if you want to display this with the armor on in the front and then on the top, you have to do this on Striker Prime. You can't do it on Jetwing Prime. This will work on Jetwing Prime, but the top stuff won't, and I'll show you that in a second. So what you want to do is there's little grooves in here. You want to slide these into the lights like such. Give you a little spin around of that, because that just looks wicked, right? All right, so you take this panel out, swing it around, and then that gives you your gas can up here, and then you swing your pipe around to the front and clip it in. The difference from Jetwing to the Striker armor is that this one's got a little extra port right here, and that's what all the armament's going to be plugging into. So you see what you got here and what's going on. Now you can take your guns, and there's a little square port right there. You plug that in, and he's starting to look awesome. Doesn't that look nice? Ooh, man. Makes me not want to transform him ever again. And if you didn't think that looked cool, how about now when you add the swords? And if you don't like the swords at the front, you can store them on the top, which kind of looks cool too. Thank you very much for watching, people. This has been Mitch Santona. You've just seen Asian exclusive Striker Optimus Prime. This thing really is excellent. My overall synopsis of this is if you've got the extra money to get it, but it's going to cost you, it's going to set you back. I'm not going to lie, this is an import that they don't sell here. So it's going to cost you around $200 to get it in. You don't have that kind of extra change rattling around, then this guy is going to be kind of out of reach for most collectors. But I think this thing is worth it to me, because this thing really is one of the better Optimi that I have. He's going to be front and center in my collection, and I'm totally digging all that shiny chrome and crazy looking shield. So folks, be sure to check out my second action figure reviewing channel. Subscribe to me there. Subscribe to me here. Thumbs up this video if you could. Leave a comment, a video response. I love those things. Let's all get involved, people. I'll see you guys later. Arrivederci, buona sera, and have a good night. One last thing, in case you were wondering, is Jetwing, Buster, Striker, Optimus Prime possible? The answer to that is ho 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 yes.